Gaming Warlord. Okay. Chat, wir gehen rein.
This is the story of a man named Stanley.
Oh.
Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month.
Geht's auf Deutsch, Nina?
Yeah. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in.
Nee.
As though he had been made exactly for this job.
Perfekt, Jungs, das ist das Leben.
Was happy.
Das ist das Leben. Sitzen
and
und
one
knöpfen.
Day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow.
Oh.
No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
Okay, wir machen Audio, wir machen Untertitel. Alle. Okay, Jungs. Wir gehen raus.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Zum Meetingraum müssen wir gehen. Der ist hier.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
okay.
He entered the door on his left.
Wir gehen rechts.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Ach ja, das ist die Lounge. Chillig.
Yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room.
Ja, das
Stanley
ist echt
simply
schön.
Stood here, drinking it all in.
Ja, das ist wunderschön hier. Okay, wir gehen weiter.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nee. Wir gehen weiter.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Fuck off.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
Ich vertraue ihm nicht.
I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not.
Ich vertraue ihm nicht.
I realize that investing in your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
Okay.
There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her. This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Sie, wer ist sie?
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this. To reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
Okay. Hallo?
Oh. Oh, Stanley, is that you? Hold on, sweetie. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven. All right.
Oh.
Okay, there we go.
Oh, sie ist süß.
All right, now, I want you to come in and tell me all about
your day.
Gotcha. Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife? Who'd want to commit their life to you? I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something.
Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Ich hab gedacht, wir haben eine Freundin.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
Wurde angeschaltet. Drücke R auf deiner Tastatur.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him. And every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence.
Na. Jetzt drück T.
Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Ich drück nicht 8. Fick dich. Ich drück nicht 8. Nö. Ich drück T. Drück R. Drück 7. Drück 9. Drück 8.
But in his mind, in his mind he can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him.
Ja, das echte Leben. 8, um fern zu sehen, okay, komm.
And so he began to fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped up from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building had suddenly vanished off the face of the earth. The thought excited him terribly.
Um Zeit mit deinen Kindern zu verbringen. Ich hab Kinder!
So, he went further. He imagined that he came to two open doors and that he could go through either. At last, choice. It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold. As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations. Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable. It was such a wonderful fantasy. And so in his head, he relived it again. And then again. And again. Over and over. Wishing beyond hope that it would never end. That he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path. Mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time.
Drücke 5, um deiner Frau zu sagen, dass ich sie liebe. Ja!
But there is no answer. How could there possibly be? In reality, all he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has. Nothing has changed. The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets. The more he forgets which life is the real one. And I'm trying to tell him this. That in this world, he can never be anything but an observer. That as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop.
Okay, ich hör auf dich.
Watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
Ich mach's nicht. Ich hör auf ihn. Ich mach's nicht. Ich drück den Knopf nicht! Do not do it!
You see? Can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's electing to kill himself? How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
Nichts in Frage zu stellen, okay.
I suppose I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled to. I must. Perhaps, well, maybe this time he'll see. Maybe this time.
Okay, ich höre jetzt auf ihn.
And I tried again. and Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again, and Stanley pushed a button. And I tried.
Okay. Okay, wir sind jetzt wieder hier.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Okay. Wir machen jetzt das, was er sagt.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Linke Tür. Wir sind brav.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Oh nein.
Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Let it ball up inside you, take it out passive aggressive. Ja.
Yo, Yiqui.
Danke, Brother. Retten mir den Tag, hab dich lieb, Nebellauf.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Ab nach oben. Alter, das ist das Büro vom Boss. Ernsthaft? Da wohnt der... Wir arbeiten in dieser Hölle und da wohnt der Boss. Junge. Ernsthaft. Das ist...
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held Love. From him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number.
2845.
Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
2845.
Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code.
Easy.
By sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Da lang. Yo! Da nach unten. Smart. Piep. Sehr smart.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long.
Sehr gut. Hier durch.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility. The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible Krass. Secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Hab ich. Das ist Webcam an.
Now the monitors jumped to life. Their
Yo.
True nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Okay. Und das ist ein Aufzug?
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Weiß
no.
Ich nicht. Nein.
Refused to believe it. He couldn't accept
Nein.
It. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content.
Oha.
Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Okay, ich soll das jetzt zerstören. Aber wie? Hiermit? Hä? Ich soll das Ding zerstören. Ah, ich soll zu dem Power-Ding gehen. Okay, 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 okay. Zu dem Power-Ding. Smart.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
Aus damit!
Blackness and a rising chill of uncertainty. Was it over? Yes. He had won. He had defeated the machine. Unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away. And yet, even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved. Where had his co-workers gone? How had he been freed from the machine's grasp? What other mysteries did this strange building hold? But as sunlight streamed into the chamber, he realized none of this mattered to him. For it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his.
Wow.
And that was all he needed to know. It was perhaps
the
only thing worth knowing. Stanley stepped through the open door. Stanley felt the cool breeze upon his skin, the feeling of liberation, the immense possibility of the new path before him. This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy.
Okay. Schön. Alright. Gut. Nochmal.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided
also es geht darum, das Spiel öfters durchzuspielen, I guess, aber mit verschiedenen Enden. Okay. We go again.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
ich gehe durch die linke Tür wieder.
The door on his left. Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office.
Wir gehen runter.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Wir gehen runter.
But Stanley just couldn't do it. He considered the possibility of facing his boss, admitting he had left his post during work hours. He might be fired for that. And in such a competitive economy, why had he taken that risk? All because he believed everyone had vanished. His boss would think he was crazy. And then something occurred to Stanley. Maybe, he thought to himself, maybe I am crazy. all of my coworkers blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment for no reason at all, none of it made any logical sense. And as Stanley pondered this, he began to make other strange observations. For example, why couldn't he see his feet when he looked down? Why did doors close automatically behind him wherever he went?
True.
And for that matter, these rooms were starting to look pretty familiar. Were they simply repeating? No, Stanley said to himself, this is all too strange. This can't be real. And at last, he came to the conclusion that had been on the tip of his tongue. He just hadn't found the words for it. I'm dreaming, he yelled. This is all a dream. Oh, what a relief Stanley felt to have finally found an answer, an explanation. His co-workers weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all. And he thought to himself, I suppose I'll wake up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring real-life job pushing buttons. I may as well enjoy this while I'm still lucid. So, he imagined himself flying and began to gently float above the ground.
Ja, ich fliege!
Then he imagined himself soaring through space on a magical star field, and it too appeared. It was so much fun, and Stanley marveled that he had still not woken up. How was he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head. One he was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner. Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking?
True.
Now the voice was describing itself being considered by Stanley, who found it particularly strange. I'm dreaming about a voice describing me, thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought. And while he thought it all very odd and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that, of course, this was not a dream. How could it be? Was Stanley simply deceiving himself, believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself? Stanley is as awake right now as he's ever been in his life.
Also wir sind wach.
Now, hearing the voice speak these words was quite a shock to Stanley. After all, he knew for certain, beyond a doubt, that this was in fact a dream. Did the voice not see him float and make the magical stars just a moment ago? How else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself too. Surely, surely, if he could just... He would prove it. He would prove that he was in control, that this was a dream. So he closed his eyes gently, and he invited himself to wake up. He felt the cool weight of the blanket on his skin, the press of the mattress on his back, the fresh air of a world outside this one. Let me wake up, he thought to himself. I'm through with this dream. I wish it to be over. Let me go back to my job. Let me continue pushing the buttons. Please, it's all I want. I want my apartment and my wife and my job. All I want is my life exactly the way it's always been. My life is normal. I am normal. Everything will be fine. I am okay.
Okay. Aber ich... Ja...
Stanley began screaming. Please, someone, wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss. I have an office. I am real. Please, just someone tell me I am real. I must be real. I must be. Can anyone hear my voice? Who am I? Who am I? And everything went black. This is the story of a woman named Mariella.
Alter.
Mariella woke up on a day like any other. She arose, got dressed, gathered her belongings, and walked to her place of work.
Oh, nein.
But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man
Sind
who had
wir
stumbled
das?
Through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk. And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance, for just a few brief moments, she considered the strange man. He was obviously crazy. This much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like. And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal. I am sane. I am in control of my mind. I know what is real and what isn't. It was comforting to think this, And in a certain way, seeing this man made her feel better. But then she remembered the meeting she had scheduled for that day. The very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career.
Yeah.
And by extension, the rest of her life. She had no time for this. So it was only a moment that she stood there, staring down at the body. And then she turned and ran.
Ja, willkommen in unserer Gesellschaft, Chat. Holy shit, das ist fucking deep. Das ist Real Talk deep. Okay, was gibt's noch?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a
Oh, fuck!
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Kann ich springen? Nee, ne? Können wir unseren Selbstmord nachstellen? Ich kann nicht springen. Ich habe gerade ein Achievement bekommen. Okay.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Schön.
Wow. Yes.
Waren wir schon?
This room. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Links.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Nee. Wir gehen runter. Wir gehen runter. Scheiß drauf. Wir gehen runter.
Stanley didn't want to go back to the office. He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now in order to get back, he needed to go from here it's left.
Hm. Links?
Oh, no. No, oh. It's to the right. My mistake.
Oh, rechts, okay.
No, 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 not the right. Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was I thinking? It's clearly... Oh, dear, would you hold on for a minute, please?
Yeah. Who is this?
Now, let's see. We went down right, left, down, left, right. Yeah, yep, okay, okay, yes. I've got it now. This story is absolutely, definitely this way.
Okay, da lang. Yo, wir sind wieder hier!
No, 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 no. This isn't right at all. You're not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler. Quick, Stanley, close your eyes. Okay, 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 okay. We just have to get back to, Who am I kidding? It's all rubbish now. The whole story completely unusable. How about, rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game from the beginning. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hm? Okay, from the top.
Was? Was war das für ein Ende? Was war das für ein Ende? Was war das für ein Ende?
All of his co-workers were gone.
Entschuldigung?
What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Beep, 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 beep. Okay. Gutes Ending. Gutes Ending. Was? Hä? Oha, ich kann die Tür schließen. Ah.
When Stanley... Wait. Wait, what? No, no, I restarted. I swear, I definitely restarted the game over. Completely fresh. Everything should be... Oh, did something change? Stanley... Did you change anything when we were back in that room with all the monitors? Did you move the story somewhere or a...
Nein.
Hold on. Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story. It was right here just a minute ago. I know for sure that it's here somewhere.
Okay, ich hab nichts gemacht. Then.
It's an adventure. Come, Stanley. Let's find the story.
Okay, nach... Nach links. Wo ist die Story? Ist das ernsthaft ein Labyrinth?
I'll say it. This is the worst adventure I've ever been on. I can promise you, there definitely was a story here before. Do we need to restart the game again? Well, I find it unlikely that we'll ever progress by starting over and over again. But it's got to be better than this. Okay, let's give it a shot. Why not?
Junge, ernsthaft? Wollt mich verarschen? Nochmal, okay?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Nochmal.
Okay, yep, it's worse. I might be remembering this wrong. It's possible the story is back where we just came from. Why don't we go back the other direction and see if we missed anything?
Nochmal zurück.
Aha! I knew we'd miss something. The story. Here it comes. No, wait. Never mind. Not the story. Okay, let's head back the other way and retrace our steps.
Junge, er fuckt so ab. Bitte, er fuckt so ab. Hä?
Now this... Well, I'll be honest, I don't recognize this place at all. Is this the story? I don't think so. I can't quite recall, but I believe my story took place in an office building. Is that correct? Do you remember, Stanley? Well, do you know what? Since I've completely forgotten what we were supposed to be doing, how about this? You win! Congratulations! I know you put in a lot of hard work, and it really paid off.
Hab ich gewonnen?
Good job.
Yeah!
Oh, no. No, I don't feel right about this at all. We both know you didn't put in any actual work for that win. Some people win fair and square, and this was not one of those situations.
Oh, ich hab doch nicht gewonnen.
I'm getting weirded out by whatever this place is. I don't care what might happen this time. I have to restart.
Ist dein fucking Ernst? Nochmal.
All right, I've got a solution. This time, to make sure we don't get lost, I've employed the help of the Stanley Parable Adventure Line. Just follow the line. How simple is that?
Insane. Wir haben's.
You see? The line knows where the story is. It's over in this direction. Onward, Stanley, to destiny. Though, here's a thought. Wouldn't wherever we end up be our destination, even if there's no story there? Or to put it another way, is the story of no destination still a story? Simply by the act of moving forward, are we implying a journey such that a destination is inevitably conjured into being via the very manifestation of the nature of life itself? Whoa. Hang on. That got a bit weird back there. Well, I'd like to apologize. Not sure where I was going with all that. You know what? I think what we need right now is a bit of music to lighten the mood.
Oh yeah, Musik.
Wait. Cut the music.
Oh.
Go back and look at that fern.
Den Farn. Das hier.
Stanley. This fern will be very important later in the story. Make sure you study it closely and remember it carefully. You won't want to miss anything.
Joa.
Sieht halt aus wie so ein... Nee, eine Pflanze. Okay. Soll ich einen Screenshot machen? Okay, ich habe einen Screenshot.
Wait, what? We're back at the office? No, no, no. Line, you do know we're looking for the Stanley Parable, right? The story? Is any of this ringing a bell?
Hä? Die Story. Da lang?
Oh, no, 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 not again. Line, how could you have done this to us? And after we trusted you, after everything we've been through, you... Oh, I can't take this anymore. To hell with it. Restart.
Imagine. Okay, haben wir es jetzt.
You know what, Stanley? I say forget the adventure line. What's it ever done for us?
Nix.
We're intelligent people, right?
Yeah.
Why can't we make up our own story? Something exciting, daring, mysterious. Oh, this all sounds perfectly doable. Why don't we simply start wandering in, well, I don't know. How about this direction?
Oh, smart, ich geh da lang. Schön.
Now, yes, this is exciting. Just me and Stanley forging a new path, a new story. Well, it could be anything. What do you want our story to be? Go wild.
Piraten-Story.
Use your imagination. Whatever it might be, Stanley, I'm ready for it.
Piraten-Story will ich.
Oh no, not you again.
Oh nein, nicht
Stanley,
die Linie.
I'd also like to veto the line from having any role in our awesome new story. No lines or monitor rooms. Just don't acknowledge it. We should be fine.
Ich schaue sie mir nicht an. Oh, sie geht wieder weg. Hallo. Oh.
Ah, a choice.
Oha.
We get to make a decision. From here, the story is in our control. How important, we mustn't squander the opportunity. In fact, I believe I need a minute to think here. Just walk in circles for a minute.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I know that each door has to lead somewhere, which means that somewhere, the place where we're trying to go, there must be a reverse door that leads here. And that in turn means that our destination corresponds with the counter-inverted reverse door's origin. So
yeah.
Starting from the right, let us ask, will taking the right door lead us to where we're going? And since the answer is clearly yes, then by all accounts, the door on the right is the correct one.
Rechte
Another
Tür.
Victory for logic. Come, Stanley, our destiny awaits.
Okay, warte. Die rechte Tür. Oh.
Oh, hold up, what's this? Hmm.
Confusing ending?
The confusion ending. You're telling me that's what this is? It's all one giant ending? And we're supposed to restart the game eight times? That's really how all this goes? It's all determined? So now, according to the schedule, I restart again. Then what? Am I just supposed to forget? Well, what if I don't want to forget? My mind goes blank simply because it's written here on this thing, wall. Well, who consulted me? Why don't I get to decide? Why don't I get a say in all of this? Is it really? No, it can't be. I don't want it to be. I don't want the game to
okay.
keep restarting. I don't want to forget what's going on.
Yeah.
I don't want to be trapped like this. I won't restart the game. I won't do it. I won't do it. I
okay,
won't
dann setz mich
do
hin.
It. And the timer stopped? Does that mean, did we do it? Did we break the cycle? The, whatever it is that made this schedule? How would we even know? Will someone come for us? Will something happen? So, okay. I guess now we just wait, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I suppose in some way that this is a kind of story, wouldn't you agree? I'm not quite
yeah.
sure if we're in the destination or the journey, though they're always saying that life is about the journey and not the destination. So I hope that's where we are right now. We'll find out, won't we?
Eventually. Well, in the meantime...
Okay.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Jetzt hat er es vergessen. Was muss ich jetzt machen? Links oder rechts?
Stanley came to a set of two open doors.
Was stand da? Was muss ich machen? Links oder rechts? Das stand noch normally, oder? Jungs. Ha. Okay, links. Ich vertraue dem einen nicht im Chat.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find a... Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office. Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley
was once again
stunned
to
discover not an indication of any human life. What could it mean? Stanley wondered aloud to nobody. He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books off the shelf, looking behind paintings, desperate for clues to his situation. But his attention was caught by a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could its purpose be? In fact, this keypad guarded the terrible secret that lay buried below his feet. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Aber warte mal, wir sind doch immer noch im Confusion Ending drin, oder? Wir sind doch immer noch im Confusion Ending drin. Ich bin verwirrt. Sind wir noch im Confusion Ending drin? Wir sind doch noch im Confusion-Ending drin. Eigentlich muss doch jetzt noch irgendwas passieren. Nein! Doch!
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Mach ich nicht.
Although this passageway had the word Escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Was? Was?
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
Warte mal, hab ich das aber geschafft? Hab ich das Confusion Ending geschafft? Haben wir es geschafft? Bin voll wieder confused.
At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Okay. Ja? Okay, rein da.
As the machine whirred into motion and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plugging the eyeballs from a blind man.
So
he resigned and willingly accepted this violent end to his brief and shallow life. Farewell, Stanley.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
Bessie.
Okay. And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game, back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
Wo bin ich?
When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
Korridor? Okay, das sind die zwei Türen. Das ist das Office. Button Sounds. Oha! Credits! Yo, das sind die Credits vom Spiel! Hä? Ich glaube, ich lebe! Office Computers. Okay. Rechts oder links? Ich geh mal links. 431. The Office. Okay. Maintenance Room. Larger. More endings, fewer endings. Okay. Die Lounge. Hä? The Cargo Lift. Apartment Timer? Null. Check wieder von vorne an. Okay. Hey, wo muss ich hin? Escape Menu. Exit.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free. Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another? No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen.
Okay.
Listen to me. You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's.
Quit! Soll ich raus?
Stop now, that'll be your only true choice.
Ich will nicht raus!
Do choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let time choose.
Okay. Das war jetzt. Sie war, glaube ich, jetzt. Sie hat mir das jetzt gesagt als Spieler. Der Narrator ist praktisch der Stanleys Leben narrated und ich bin der Spieler und sie redet mit dem Spieler. Sie redet mit dem Spieler. Hallo? Hallo? Bin ich tot? Hallo? Zurück zum Menü.
This is the story of.
Warte, was? Hab ich jetzt neu. Ist es so richtig?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he simply missed a memo.
Was zur Hölle? Ich verstehe absolut gar nichts mehr. Piep, 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 piep. Ich check absolut gar nichts.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Ich bin die Treppe schon runtergegangen.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Kann ich Minecraft zocken? Ja, gute Idee, Bro.
Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Hope coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Okay, wir geben jetzt mal den Code falsch ein. Was? Business-Strategie, den Panda töten? Okay, ich bin jetzt im Fahrstuhl. Tanz mit Chat. Das Spiel ist echt fucking gut. Reader, das Spiel ist insane gut. Das ist einfach ein Spiel, was einen wirklich mal fordert auf einen anderen Weg. Das ist nicht so, oh, es ist ein Shooter, es ist ein Battle Royale, das ist irgendwas anderes mal wenigstens. Wir sind wieder hier. Yo, danke Eric Goat. Bruh, der macht absolut gar nichts. Das ist ein absoluter Scam-Aufzug. Was ist das denn?
The moment he entered his manager's office, Stanley froze in his tracks. Not a living soul anywhere. Could he really be all alone? This was too much for Stanley to take, too much for any man to take. He fell to his knees, bursting into half moans, half sobs, the guttural retching of life from a man denied any hope, any reason to keep going. Here on the floor, he lay prone, paralyzed by fear for nearly a full hour. But when at last he began to move about and survey the situation, he found a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could it mean? Was it a sign of hope for Stanley's future? Alas, it was not. For although this keypad guarded the terrible secret of Stanley's past, it had been assigned a 4-digit code so devious and so random that no man could ever hope to guess it. 2845. Statistically, nearly impossible to guess blindly ever.
Ich will jetzt was Falsches eingeben, vielleicht passiert dann was.
Stanley simply began entering random codes into the keypad, knowing full well the sheer statistical unlikelihood that this would ever result in a correct combination. If he knew that the combo was 2845, it would be another story entirely. But no, no, this is what he was going to do instead.
Ja, stimmt. Lass mich doch.
Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845.
Nein. Ich gib's nicht ein.
turns out that the panel's emergency override kicked in, and the door just opened all by itself.
Oha!
And Stanley got the hell along with the story. Well, whoop-de-doo.
Easy! Ich wusste es. Outsmarted. Yo, Hokage auf Avocados, danke für den Resub. Whee! Wir sind wieder hier.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Zack.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens.
Nein.
What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
So, zack.
Now the
diesmal drücken wir auf den On-Knopf.
Their true nature revealed.
On-Knopf.
Each bore the number of an employee in the building. Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen.
Gibt's ja nicht.
Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Jungs, das ist mein Setup, by the way. Ich habe so ein Setup hier und da sehe ich eure Webcams. Alle.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Und hier drauf.
No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable. Wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Okay, Chat.
But it was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad.
Wir drücken jetzt auf on.
Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Okay. On. 5.
Oh, Stanley. You didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control?
Yeah.
Oh, Stanley. I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are set to explode, eliminating the entire complex. How long until detonation then? Let's say, 2 minutes. Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't
it,
Stan?
Oh, shit!
It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated. All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever,
pushing
buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside.
Ich habe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gedrückt.
I have to say this, though. This version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich.
Aber es bringt nichts, weil die Kontrolle hat.
But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much. You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock, why not?
Extra Zeit.
These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh dear me, what's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now?
Yeah.
Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off?
Yeah, habe ich wirklich gedacht.
Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons. No, these colored ones. Or maybe this big red button. Or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me.
Yeah.
Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? Won? Solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is? Stanley. You're in for quite a disappointment.
Okay, dann gehe ich wieder zurück.
But here's a spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless.
Da passiert auch nichts.
To see you made humble. This is not a challenge. It's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't. Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle.
Yeah.
30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending. Just you being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life? Or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice? Make it count. Or don't. It's all the same to me. All a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life
from the moment we fade in
until the moment I say happily ever up.
Yo, Vini, danke für den Raid, brother. Danke, Homie. Kuss. Alter! Und jetzt hat es in die Luft gejagt. Okay, ich glaube, das Ziel ist, wir dürfen nicht ihm zu viel hören, aber ihm zu viel befolgen, aber auch nicht zu wenig. Nicht zu viel, aber auch nicht zu wenig.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Warum ist es auf einmal kürzer? Warum ist es kürzer?
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Yeah, hier waren wir schon.
The lounge was sublime, a work of art. What was it about but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago. But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Ja, danke, brav, aber WTF? Hä? Wo bin ich denn jetzt?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story in any way.
Whiteboard ending! Wir haben das Whiteboard ending! No way! Jungs, das Spiel ist insane gut!
Das ist so gut. Ich glaube, es wird sogar Game of the Year, ne? Mal früher. Das ist wirklich, wirklich ein fantastisches Spiel. Holy shit. So können Spiele sein. Imagine. Stell dir mal vor, jemand macht wirklich was Kreatives und nicht immer nur dieselbe Scheiße für 20 Jahre. Okay. When
Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well.
Real talk. Ja, ich weiß,
perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Standing now in this incredible room, Stanley for the first time understood, but eager to get back to business. Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Okay, wir waren schon mal ganz geradeaus, aber vielleicht macht jetzt irgendwas anderes.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Jo, warte mal, da ist eine offene Tür.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
Da können wir, glaube ich, rein. Ja, da können wir rein, da können wir rein.
I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you.
What? Really?
Ja.
I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful.
Du zeigst mir gar nichts.
Let me prove that I'm on your side.
Ja, komm.
Give me a chance.
Zeig's mir.
Now listen carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
Ja. Bruder, ich bin farbenblind.
Aha. Perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door.
Nope.
I still don't think we're communicating properly. Stanley walked. All right, fine. Go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen?
Well,
don't let me stop you.
Was ist in der blauen Tür?
You see? There's nothing here. I haven't even finished building this section of the map because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you?
Schon cool.
Do you not think I put a lot of time into that? Because I did. And in the end, it was all for nothing. Because this is what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Work with me. You give me absolutely nothing so far.
Oh, skill tree wäre sick.
Let me take a stab in the dark at a new design and you can give me some feedback.
Okay, komm heraus.
There we go. A third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin.
Eine dritte Option.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version.
Ja.
Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here.
Okay, Bro, das war Real Talk, da geht mehr.
A one? I mean, I can understand if you had reservations, you saw ways the game could be improved to more fully express itself mechanically and artistically, but a one? That's not even helpful.
Geht besser.
What am I supposed to do with that? But I guess it isn't my place to judge. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
Okay. The Stanley Parable Worldwide Leaderboard. Yo! Holy shit!
Now, would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep walking through doors? Again, honest answers, please.
Nicht wirklich. Obwohl.
Hey,
besser.
I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting.
Ja.
You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you?
Ja, na komm.
Let me boot it up.
Das Spiel?
In this game, the baby crawls left towards danger. You click the button to move him back to the right.
Okay.
And if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game. all about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of family life. I think the art world will really take notice. But of course, the message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective?
Wird gemacht.
Be sure to keep notes on your experience.
Wird gemacht, Brav.
You heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because if it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of ideas. I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me. I'm not even going to try. I'm out. I'm out. I'm done. It's over. Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable.
Kein Ding, bro.
Hey, since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game? Just to ease the pain.
Okay.
Let's see. What do we have here? Yes. This seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot.
Okay, neues Game.
Well, Stanley, is this any better? At last, the one thing you've always desired. A game I had absolutely nothing to do with.
Was?
Is it enough? Tell me that, Stanley. Will it ever be enough? Well, I'll say this. I'm done making things for you.
Was?
From now on, I will only create to fulfill a greater artistic purpose. Watch this, Stanley. I'm going to build a house.
Yo!
This will go here. No, here. And then...
Wie geil ist das denn?
Let's see, what does it need? Yes, of course. And just to finish it all off... Yes.
This fucking trash.
It's complete. I made this, Stanley. Look at it. Gaze upon my work of art and feel ashamed at your own inadequacy.
It's fucking trash.
But you've only seen it from the outside. You've only gotten half the experience. Please, step inside and make yourself comfortable.
Alrighty.
Isn't it grand? Isn't it perfect? It could only be better if... Wait, that's it. We must rebuild it out of diamond.
Oh!
Diamond everything. Yes, yes, yes. Come along, Stanley. We have to go mining.
Mining? Ah! Yo, Diaz Farm!
Oh, cool. It looks like it's going to get a bit dark. Have you brought a light?
Ich hab, BAC. Oha! Oha, wie cool!
No, this is far more open-ended than I had in mind. I'm looking for something more narrow and linear. Something that makes you feel utterly irrelevant. This won't do at all, 1 out of 5. Even the diamonds couldn't save this one. Okay,
ich hätte Spinne. Was? Hallo, ich wollte Minecraft spielen! Was?
Yes, I don't even know what this game is, but I love it.
Was?
You, trapped in a glass box with no way out, listening to me talk. Oh, it's inspired. I couldn't have done it any better myself. What is this game even supposed to be? I can't figure it out.
Yo!
Okay, now I'm curious. Let's go find out what the hell this is.
Ist einfach Portal. Ich kann immer noch nicht springen.
Oh, it's a puzzle. Critical thinking, Stanley. Your forte.
Das ist halt voll real Portal. Es fühlt sich genauso an. Es fühlt sich genauso an wie Portal.
No, actually, you know what? I think that's plenty.
Okay.
I really don't care much to see you stumble through any more of these games. And I highly doubt you're any wiser for the experience. Which is why, rather than continue to waste my time, I'm just going to leave you here. You can pretend you've beaten the game if it makes it any richer for you, but as for me,
runter?
I've had enough.
Was? Okay. Ist fucking dunkel hier drin. Hallo? Ist es jetzt ein Horrorspiel? Nein, oder? Oh! Dahin! Hier 27. Yo! Das ist mein alter, das ist mein Arbeitsplatz, aber es ist eine Scuffed-Version. Ist es die Source 1-Version von meinem Arbeitsplatz?
I wonder what he found. If what he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story, well, perhaps he's gotten it. Down in wherever he is right now. I wonder if he's happy with his choice. And if he's learned the heavy cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end to make sense out of the chaos and the fear and the confusion. That's who I am. That is what I mean to this world. Oh, yes. Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way. Once this ends, after it all comes to a close, then I'll be back. The end will be here soon. Very soon.
Okay.
I can wait.
Yeah? Oh, es geht weiter. Okay. Interessant. Ich lebe wieder.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Ersten Raum, rechter Schreibtisch am Fenster. Erster Raum.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Sitz im Stuhl und krabbel über ihn auf. Wie? Wie? Andere Seite von dem. Oh. Oh. Da? Da? Oh. Yo!
At first, Stanley assumed he'd broken the map until he heard this narration and realized it was part of the game's design all along.
Oh my god.
He then praised the game for its insightful and witty commentary into the nature of video game structure and its examination of structural narrative tropes. So, now that you're here, what do you think? Isn't this a fun and unique place to be?
Retalk, it's echt cool.
Why don't we take a minute just to drink it all in? Okay, I'm over it now. What do you think? Are you sick of this gag yet?
Nö.
Ah, then in that case, we'll continue. But now, here comes the real question. What do you think would have happened if you had told me that you wanted this to stop? Do you think it would have been particularly different? Would I have taken the same idea, but rephrased it superficially to fit that answer? Perhaps you never would even have thought of it if I hadn't brought up the issue in the first place. Oh, now think about it. Will it be worth it for you to restart and then come back here just to do the other option? Clearly, this whole gag takes some time. What if the other option is even longer? How long will you spend in total just to have heard all the narration? Oh, and this is rich. Perhaps you've just played the other option, and now you've come to see what happens in this one. So, what do you think? Which choice was the better one? Imagine if you had selected continue on your first playthrough, how tantalizing it would be not knowing what happens when you pick the other option. Indeed, you are one of the lucky ones. Though if the other option is really miserable to listen to, then perhaps you're not. In fact, I'm just going to say that no one who's listening to this is lucky. Well now, I've built up the other option so much that I'm going to stop talking and leave you to your decision whether to come back here, continue with the game, or just sit in this spot forever and ever. Cheers.
Warte, was? Warte, was? Was muss ich jetzt machen? Ich hab gar nicht aufgepasst. Neu starten. Oh mein Gott! Ha. Okay. Neu starten. Ich starte neu. Scheiß drauf. Nein, Jungs, ich mag eben nichts auf meiner Tastatur ein. Ich spoiler mich nicht. Spoiler Andy ist weg.
What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps
okay, diesmal gehen wir durch die rote Tür. Was? Ach so, ich habe selber zugemacht. Oh, ich depp. So.
When Stanley came to a set of two open, this was not the correct way to the meeting room.
Geh durch die rote.
Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Stanley felt lightheaded, butterflies in his stomach, giddy in a but eager to get back to business. Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nee. Ich gehe jetzt durch die rote Tür.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Yo, too lazy to choose a name, danke für den resub.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story...
What? Really?
I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why... I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance. Now listen carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
Okay, jetzt ab durch die rote Tür.
Oh, thank God you are willing to listen to me. Do you see that I really have wanted you to be happy all this time? The problem is all these choices. The two of us always trying to get somewhere that isn't here. Running and running and running, just the way you're doing right now. Don't you see that it's killing us, Stanley? I wanted to stop. We would both be so much happier if we just stopped.
Okay.
And I think I have a solution. Here, let me show you.
Here? Was? Zwei Türen?
What do we want? What are we looking for?
Was ist das?
Here.
Oha!
Oh, it's beautiful, isn't it?
Sterni.
If we just stay right here, right in this moment with this place, Stanley, I think I feel happy. I actually feel happy.
Isn't happy. Wow. Ist das eine ein Polarlichter? Tiny. Okay. Es geht weiter. Yo, Grizzlies. Wow. Grizzlefreunde. Alrighty. Ich geh weiter. Ja, genug Grizzly.
No, wait. Where are you going?
Hm? Nochmal?
Nee, ich will weg.
Oh no. Stay away from those stairs. If you hurt yourself, if you die, the game will reset. We'll lose all of this.
Ich sterb schon nicht. Ich sterb nicht.
Please, no, Stanley, let me stay here. Don't take this from me.
Chad? Chad?
Please, Stanley, think about what you're doing.
Wie ist da noch was?
No! Oh, thank God, you lived.
Oh.
You had me worried there for a moment. Now, can we please get back to the other room?
No. Nochmal.
No, no, what are you doing, Stanley? Please, I'm asking you not to take this away from me. I can't go back to what I was before. If you die, we'll both go back. Why are you doing this?
Oh Gott, ich sterb eh nicht. Ja,
Stanley,
ich sterb eh nicht.
Let's go back to the other room.
Ich sterb eh nicht, weil er Kontrolle hat. Er hat Kontrolle. Ich hab.
Really how much you dislike my game? That you'll throw yourself from this platform over and over to be rid of it? You were literally willing to kill yourself to keep me from being happy. Am I reading the situation correctly?
Okay, wir gehen einmal kurz zurück.
Maybe you just, you actually want to stay alive, or are you just teasing me?
Okay.
I wanted us to be happy here, Stanley. I really did. I wish I still thought that was possible.
Ich bin wieder zurück. Ich bin wieder zurück. Jetzt bin ich doch wieder zurück. Jetzt ist doch alles gut. Aber er macht nichts. Ja, komm, ich geh wieder hoch. Ich spring nochmal runter. Da war noch eine Tür. Die geht aber nicht. Egal, one more time. Whee!
Is it over? It's going to restart, isn't it? I'm going back.
Oh nein.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Was ist das hier auf dem Boden?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Hallo?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay, was haben wir noch nicht gemacht? Rechts haben wir alles gemacht, theoretisch, oder? Egal, wir gehen einfach mal links. Noch nicht?
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Okay.
Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Zu Ende. Oh! Oh!
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
Nö. Bleib hier. Jungs, wenn ihr gerade erst einschaltet, wir haben schon ziemlich viel gemacht.
Nothing here. No choice to make, no
wir spielen das seit anderthalb Stunden.
Just an empty broom closet. No reason to still be here.
Ich mag das. Max hier.
It was baffling that Stanley was still just sitting in the broom closet. He wasn't even doing anything. At least if there was something to interact with, he'd be justified in some way. As it is, he's literally just standing there doing sweet FA.
Ich mach doch was. Chille.
Are you really still in the broom closet? Standing around doing nothing? Why? Please offer
was.
Me some explanation here. I'm genuinely confused.
Ich mach was.
You do realize there's no choice or anything in here, right? If I'd said Stanley walked past the broom closet, At least she would have had a reason for exploring it to find out. But it didn't even occur to me, because literally, this closet is of absolutely no significance to the story whatsoever.
Ja, aber wenn ich lange hier bleibe, dann macht er ja daraus eine Story. Wenn ich hier bleibe, dann macht er ja eine Story.
Maybe to you, this is somehow its own branching path. Maybe when you go talk about this with your friends,
you'll say,
"Oh, did you get the broom closet ending? The broom closet ending was my favorite." I hope your friends find this concerning.
Oh my god, Alter, Jungs, er ist so aware. Er ist so fucking aware.
Stanley was fat and ugly and really, really stupid. He probably only got the job because of a family connection. That's how stupid he is. That or with drug money. Also, Stanley is addicted to drugs and hookers.
Okay.
Well, I've come to a very definite conclusion about what's going on right now. You're dead. You got to this broom closet, explored it a bit, and were just about to leave because there's nothing here, when a physical malady of some sort shut down your central nervous system and you collapsed on the keyboard. In a situation like this, the responsible thing is to alert someone nearby so as to ensure that your body is taken care of before it begins to decompose. Hello? Anyone who happens to be nearby? The person at this computer is dead.
Ich bin nicht tot.
He or she has fallen prey to any number of your countless human physiological vulnerabilities. It's indicative of the long-term sustainability of your species. Please remove their corpse from the area and instruct another human to take their place at the computer, making sure they understand basic first-person video game mechanics and filling them in on the history of narrative tropes in video gaming, so that the irony and insightful commentary of this game is not lost on them. All right, when you've done that, just step out into the hallway.
Not gonna happen, mate. Das wird nicht passieren, ich bleib hier drin. Das wird nicht passieren, ich bleib hier drin. Kann man nicht noch irgendwas machen? Soll ich ihn baiten?
Ah, second player. You too? Unbelievable. I'm at the mercy of an entire species of invalids. Perhaps there's a monkey nearby you can hand the controls to. A fish? Fungus? Look, you can hammer out the details. I'm not particularly picky. I'll just be waiting for when you're ready to pick up the story again.
Okay. Ja, komm, wir werden jetzt auf ihn zu verarschen. Hallo, hat's geklappt? Er sagt nichts. Okay.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Wir haben das schon gemacht, oder? Haben wir hier oben schon alles gemacht? Wir haben hier oben schon alles gemacht. Oh! Because the boss knows that what the boss says goes if the boss suffered losses. Okay. Time. Wir haben aber unten haben wir schon. Unten waren wir schon, Chat. Ich war schon unten einmal. Was war nochmal der Code? Was war nochmal der Code? Zwei, acht, vier, fünf. Okay. Hat nichts gebracht.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any. Stanley was in such a rush to get through the story as quickly as possible, he didn't even have a single minute to just let the narrator talk. That kind of anxiety isn't healthy. so he relaxed for a few moments with some calming New Age music.
Yo. Oh, das chillt echt. Das chillt echt.
Feeling soothed and rejuvenated, Stanley calmly walked forward into the opened passageway.
Okay, hier waren wir jetzt aber schon. Warte. Zurück? Ha. Keine Ahnung. Ich guck mal. Okay, jetzt können wir nicht nochmal drücken. Aber da haben wir schon auf On-Off gedrückt. Nochmal rein. Ah, genau, wir können quitten, theoretisch.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Gibt's ein offizielles Ende, wo dann kommt irgendwie, du hast das Spiel durchgespielt oder so?
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track. At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Ich bin verwirrt. Okay. Ich glaube, wir haben wirklich fast alles. Ich glaube, wir haben for real fast alles. Wir haben wirklich fast alles.
As the machine whirred into motion and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man. So he resigned and willingly accepted this violent end to his brief and shallow life.
Okay, jetzt kommt die andere Stimme.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated, as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him.
Können wir jetzt schon theoretisch rausgehen? Nee, oder? Nee.
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game, back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
Okay.
When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
Okay, also es gibt trotzdem dieselben Enden. Okay. Aber jetzt, genau, hier ist der Knopf. Und dann drücken wir auf. Und dann quitten wir davor.
How they wish to destroy one another.
Oder es ist genau dasselbe dann.
How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free.
Verstehe es nicht.
Can you see how much they need one another? No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen.
Any struggles?
But listen to me. You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and... Press quit.
So. Jetzt habe ich es neu gestartet.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Jungs, wenn ich spiele das seit fast 2 Stunden. Wenn ihr seit einer Stunde dabei wart, wir haben schon sehr viele Sachen gemacht. Alrighty? Wir haben schon Real Talk sehr viele Sachen gemacht. Warum ist das auf einmal so lang?
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors,
okay,
he entered the door on his left. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
The lounge was grand. Ich glaube, ich habe es gleich. Majestic. Rote Tür waren wir auch, perhaps, da waren wir doch gerade eben. Nee. Besenkammer war ich doch auch schon. Hallo? Wir waren doch schon aus dem Fenster. Chat? Holy shit!
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago. Look, Stanley, I think
okay,
perhaps we've
hier
gone
haben wir alles gemacht. Da können wir nicht durch, ja?
Really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her. This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside.
Kann ich hier was anderes wählen?
Into your life. She's been waiting.
Jo, da unten geht's irgendwo lang. Da unten geht's irgendwo lang. Wenn ich auf den Kisten lande, lebe ich dann? Oh, hier kann man einen Telefonstecker ziehen. Okay. Telefonstecker kann man ziehen. Ah, jetzt ist das Telefon. Ja.
That's her, Stanley. Oh, no, you can't. Did you just unplug the phone?
Ja.
Now, that wasn't supposed to be a choice. How did you do that? You actually chose incorrectly?
Danke.
I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check. No, it's definitely here, clear as day. Stanley picks up the phone. He's taken to his apartment where he finds his wife, and the two pledge themselves to one another. Music comes in, fade to white, roll credits.
Sure, buddy.
Not picking up the phone is actually somehow an incorrect course of action. How is that even possible? None of these decisions were supposed to mean anything. I don't understand. How on earth are you making meaningful choices? What did you... Wait a second. Did I just see... No, that's not possible. I can't believe it. How had I not noticed it sooner? You're not Stanley. You're a real person. I can't believe I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect choices. And to think I've been letting you run around in this game for so long. If you've made any more wrong choices, you might have negated it entirely. It's as though you completely ignored even the most basic safety protocol for real-world decision-making. Or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch. I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision making in the real world. Please observe this helpful instructional video.
All right.
Choice. It's the best part of being a real person. But if used incorrectly, it can also be the most dangerous. For example, in this scenario, a hypothetical real person named Stephen has a choice.
Yeah.
He could spend years helping improve the quality of life for citizens of impoverished third world nations. Or he could systematically set fire to every orphan living in a 30-kilometer radius of his house. Which choice would you make? Remember that unlike here, the real world makes sense, and at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic. If you find yourself speaking with a person who does not make sense, in all likelihood, that person is not real. Allow the person to finish their thought Then provide an excuse why you cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice saying, My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back second crack.
Oh. Practice.
Excellent. Making choices on a regular basis is the best part to a healthy decision-making process.
Okay.
Most medical professionals recommend making at least 8 choices per day. Do you make more than 8? Less? And finally, if you begin to wonder if your choices are actually meaningful and whether you'll ever make a significant contribution to the world, just remember that in the vast infiniteness of space, your thoughts and problems are materially insignificant, and the feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you in an exercise to test and reinforce the material covered in this video.
Okay.
Welcome back. You may have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry. Now that you're properly informed on good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made just a few minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
Alrighty. Oh, wir können hier nicht runter.
Now that we know your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and dying. Imagine the main character dying senselessly halfway through the story. That story would make no sense at all. We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse. Unfortunately, it seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
All right. Cargo lift? 5000? Do not jump? Okay. Das heißt, sie haben sich ein paar Sachen verändert. I guess. Und jetzt?
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending, the story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the real world.
Alright. Schön.
Now remember, all you need to do is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
All okay, right. Jed, was machen wir jetzt?
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors, he entered the door.
Was machen wir jetzt? Was machen wir jetzt? Oh fuck, ich bin raus. Was machen wir jetzt? Rechts.
No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back in the other direction. Perhaps we're not too late.
Alter, ist einfach alles verbuggt. Okay. Nochmal. Ah, okay, geht nicht. Es ist schon vorbei. Okay, Smiley. Dann hier lang.
Oh, it's ruined. I can't believe after everything we talked about that you, my story, you've destroyed my work. Why? For what? What did you get out of that? What did you think was so special about seeing the game undone, left here like so much garbage? It's worthless now. And what am I supposed to do? Even if there were a way to continue, would it be worth it? To know that my story is now incorrect? How can I go back to that? I can't erase that knowledge. I'll have to live with it forever. Reliving its impossibility forever. I couldn't live that way. Is it better to shut the game down entirely? To willingly destroy all of my work? I don't know. What's the answer? What do I do?
What do I do?
No, I have to. I have to shut the game down.
Nein, warte noch.
I have to.
Ich wollte hier rüber.
I have to.
Ich wollte hier rüber!
Thought you were so clever. Now look where we are.
Oh, das sind die zwei Türen.
The game is destroyed. It was the only thing in the world that was mine, and you've run it into the ground. What did you think that would be funny?
You just had to see. Didn't I impress upon you how important it was to be like Stanley? He actually knows how to do what I tell him to. He understands that if I say to do something, there's a damn good reason for it.
Okay.
That thought hadn't even occurred to you, had it?
Wie mein Vater.
That there's a world outside of you. You're a child. Oh, my story. If you'd just gone through the door on the left, you would have seen it. There was a whole underground facility. You would have destroyed it and been victorious. It would have been so perfect. I worked so hard on it. I tried so hard. Is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
okay, jetzt links.
He entered the door on his left.
Okay, dann gehen wir jetzt links. Schön.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his
boss's office. Man kann gar nicht mehr runter. Okay. Hä?
Stepping inside his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, was? Unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this, until he saw the door with a voice receiver next to it.
Yeah.
Surely behind this door lay all the answers to his questions. And beyond all probability, he knew the passcode. He had seen it on his boss's computer just last week. Nightshark 115. Was this the code to open the door? Would it still work? There was only one way to find out. Stanley had been trained never to speak up, but now he would draw from within himself the courage to face the unknown. He drew a sharp breath and then spoke the code.
Was war nochmal der Code? Night Shark 115.
Stanley spoke the code. Night Shark 115.
Night Shark 115.
Right there on the wall.
Night Shark 115. Night Shark 115.
I'm sorry, is there a problem? You didn't mishear me, did you?
2845.
Please speak the code into the receiver. Otherwise, we can't get on with the story. This
Night
is a
Shark
crucial
115.
Step.
Junge, ich kann nicht sprechen. Ich push to
okay,
talk.
Fine, you're not gonna do it, but you know what? It's pretty humiliating to bring you this far, only for you to suddenly decide you have better things to do. I asked you for this one single thing, for your respect. The kind of respect Stanley shows for his choices. He knows what it means to take a story seriously. If you didn't want to see what I had to show you, then why did you come here? You had a choice, you know. You
Rob, could have gone through the door on the right.
You could have done whatever the hell you wanted over there. Why did you come this way? Speak. Say something to me. Explain yourself, you coward. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
was?
He entered the door on his left. Stanley? Hello? Are you... Is everything okay? Stanley, please. I need you to make a choice. I need you to walk through the door.
The end?
Are you listening to me?
Thank you for playing the Stanley Parable. Yo!
Is everything all right? Stanley, this is important.
Holy shit, wir haben's actually! Oder?
Without you. Do you understand me? Whatever choice you make is just fine. They're both correct. You cannot be wrong here. We can work together. I'll accept whatever you do. I simply need you to take that step forward, please.
Yo!
Choose?
Redog, das war insane.
Anything? This is more important than you can ever know. I need this. The story needs it. So, you hear me? Are you there? Are you listening to this? Stanley, are you there?
Bin da.
Okay. It's okay, I can wait. You need time to decide.
Time
to make sure your choice is correct. That is the best choice. That's all right.
Okay. Was für süß.
Er wollte eigentlich nur eine schöne Story schreiben, ne? Er wollte einfach nur einem seine Story zeigen. Eigentlich. Weg.
Yo!
A soft wind blew outside and perhaps rain started. And if it did, it stopped shortly after. Stanley hoped that he would one day see weather.
Was? Wetter. Ah. Okay. Und jetzt?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Ist aber schon... Ja. Nochmal? Nochmal? Telefon haben wir schon gemacht.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go.
Oh no, not again. I won't be part of this. I'm not going to encourage you. I'm not going to say anything at all. I'm just going to be patient and wait for you to finish whatever it is you enjoy doing so much in this room. Please take your time.
Jungs, soll ich einfach kurz hier stehen bleiben und, darf ich mir ein Monster holen? Darf ich mir noch was zu trinken holen, Chat? Ja, okay, ich bleib einfach kurz im Raum stehen. Was, soll ich euch ein bisschen Musik anmachen? Warte mal, ich mach euch mal, Elevator Music an. Gibt's gleich.
Thank you.
Was geht ab, Gamer? Oh, ich hab gesaved. Ups. Okay. Ist irgendwas passiert? Nein, oder? Okay. Genug Raumi. Genug Raum.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
50er Combo haben wir geschafft. Alrighty. Jetzt sind wir wieder hier.
Okay, I think we all know the drill by now. Blah, blah, blah. Dark secrets, the keypad. Stanley pushes some buttons. Oh, hey, look, it's a new passageway.
Oh ja.
Kill surprise.
Neuer Passageway. Okay, gibt jetzt hier ein anderes Ending? Schön. Weiter geht's.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Was muss ich machen? Einfach weiter, ne? Fuck it.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Hab ich.
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building. Stanley's
no way.
The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen. And Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing. This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
All right.
No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable. Wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Und jetzt?
Here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place.
Und jetzt?
As the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would
Chat,
never
jetzt?
Again exert its terrible power
auf ja drücken,
over another
mal.
Human life.
Auf,
for
auf.
He would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Keine Ahnung. Okay, ihr shrugged. Ich hab schon on gedrückt. Ich hab schon on gedrückt. Ich offe jetzt nochmal. Fuck it.
Blackness and a rising chill of uncertainty. Was it over? Yes. He had won. He had defeated the machine. Unshackled himself from someone else's
Let's
command.
Go!
Freedom was near moments away.
Yo, Phoenix, thanks for five up.
Even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved.
Okay, wir haben es nochmal geschafft.
His co-workers gone? How had he been freed from the machine's grasp?
Wir hatten das schon mal.
What mysteries did this strange building hold? But as sunlight streamed into the chamber, he realized none of this mattered to him. For it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever
ich geh nicht
life
raus.
Lives,
It will be.
Yo, Free Scout, danke für Resub, danke, brother.
It was perhaps.
Und Dire Wolf, danke für Resub. Ich geh nicht raus. Ich geh nicht raus. Geh nicht raus. Yo, der Scam Trainer. Passiert nichts.
Stanley felt the cool breeze upon his skin. A feeling of liberation, the immense possibility of the new path before him. This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy.
Ich chat, wir haben alles. Wir haben alles. Okay, was ist das mit den Zetteln? Jetzt haben wir wieder das mit den Zetteln.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Nein.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a
Hä? Moment. Jetzt haben wir wieder das mit den Zetteln. Was muss ich machen? Was muss ich machen? Ne?
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference,
doch.
Nor did it advance the story in any way.
Fenster waren wir auch schon. Das bringt nichts, wenn ich Nein, Ja drücke. Dann muss ich mir nur irgendwelche Kacke anhören.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the
door. Wir haben links legit alles gemacht. Wir haben no joke alles gemacht.
Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Treppenhaus nach unten waren wir auch schon. Wir haben alles gemacht. Alles, alles, alles.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Da waren wir überall auch schon.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door and got back on track.
Kann ich?
Stanley was so bad at following directions,
no joke.
It's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Hier unten ist noch irgendwas. Kann ich da unten irgendwie, kann ich da unten auf so Kartons drauf? Kann ich da irgendwas machen? Weil hier unten kann man irgendwie rein. Kann ich da unten rein? Screenshot von der Pflanze.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot. I'm not your enemy, but in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one has to
tell him
what to do, Stanley left from the platform and
plunged to his death. Danke, Bro. Jungs, wir haben vor real alles gemacht. Wir haben vor real alles gemacht.
Stanley simply couldn't handle the pressure. What if he had to make a decision? What if a crucial outcome fell under his responsibility? He had never been trained for that. No. This couldn't go any way except badly. The thing to do now, Stanley thought to himself, is to wait. Nothing will hurt me. Nothing will break me. In here I can be happy forever. I will be happy. Stanley waited. Hours passed, then days. Had years gone by? He no longer had the ability to tell. But the one thing he knew for sure, beyond any doubt, was that if he waited long enough, the answers would come. Eventually, someday, they would arrive. Soon, very soon now, this will end. He will be spoken to. He will be told what to do. Now it's just a little bit closer. Now it's even closer. Here it comes.
Hä? Die rechte Tür? 60 mal anklicken. Ernsthaft. Da passiert absolut gar nichts.
Stanley stood for a long time in one spot. It's part of a game. He likes to see how long he can go without dying. So far, he's doing excellent. And if he just stays right where he is, I'm sure he'll keep up that good momentum. Let's observe the genius at work.
Das ist nicht die falsche Tür. Die erste Tür, rechts. Das ist nicht die falsche Tür! Haben wir es bald? 430? Bei wie viel bin ich? Ich habe nicht mitgezählt. Neunundfünfzig. Gleich. Mit 20 bin ich. Nee, mehr.
All of his co-workers would go. Oh, please. Are you really just doing this for the achievement? Click a door 5 times. Is that all that you think an achievement is worth? No, 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 no.
Die falsche Tür.
I can't just give these merits away for such little effort. A measly 5 clicks. Now suppose you were to click the door 20 times. I would say that's the kind of effort that warrants recognition.
Ernsthaft? Es war die falsche Tür.
I have to say, I'm still not feeling the satisfaction of witnessing true effort for a noble cause. Perhaps 50 clicks will do it. Yes, almost certainly 50 clicks. No, no, I'm still not feeling it. I want this achievement to have meant something. It has to be a true reward for valiant effort. I want to see some hustle, Stanley. I want to see commitment, a willingness to go all the way, no matter what the cost. Why don't you go put 20 clicks into door number 417?
417.
Oh, great. Now, go click a few times on door 437.
Okay. Da.
Excellent.
I think we're getting somewhere. Now, door 415. Let's give it 10 clicks or so.
415. Okay, wird gemacht. Smart.
Now, back to door number 437.
Okay. Das ist für ein Ending. Das ist ein absoluter Bebega-Ending.
Let's see. How about you click on, well, I don't know, the copy machine?
Kopierer.
All right, back to room 417. I'm really feeling it now. I think we're getting somewhere.
417.
Okay, now go climb on employee 419's desk.
419.
Yes, this is great. You're putting it all on the line, Stanley. I like that. All right, let's keep it up. Go give me a few clicks on door 416. We've almost got it. Now the copy machine, do that one again.
Okay. Oha! Jungs, ich bin fucking insane.
Finish it off, Stanley. 5 clicks on door 4. Yes!
Yo!
We did it! Oh, wow. That felt amazing. Oh, you really earned it, Stanley. Nothing could hold you back. Yes, I'm very proud of how far we've come today.
Wie?
Just think, only a few minutes ago, you believed an achievement was worth 5 little clicks. Really now, what were you thinking?
Chat, no joke, wir haben alles. Wir haben alles! Ich glaube, jetzt haben wir wirklich alles. Also alles, was crazy ist.
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors,
okay, was machen wir dann?
He entered the door on his left.
Mit dem Fahren. Warte, soll ich den Screenshot angucken von dem Fahren? Ich habe einen Screenshot gemacht von dem Fahren, aber das hat meinen kompletten... Jungs. Ich habe einen Screenshot von einem Fahren gemacht. Aber es hat absolut nichts gebracht. Das Baby. Jungs, ich mache jetzt nicht 4 Stunden dieses dumme Babyspiel.
This was not the correct
way. Also wir haben theoretisch noch 4 Stunden Zeit. Wir können 4 Stunden noch das Babyspiel spielen.
Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. It was okay. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago. Look, Stanley,
okay,
I think
wir gehen nochmal in das Spielezentrum.
I'm not your enemy, really.
Aber das letzte, was wir machen. Das ist das letzte Ending, was wir machen. Spielezentrum.
But the fact is that
what? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why?
Spielende.
I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it.
Heaven ending hatten wir auch schon. Jungs, wir hatten Safe Call 20 Endings.
Now listen carefully.
No
this
joke.
Is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
Yo.
Aha. Perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door. I still don't think we're communicating properly. All right, fine, go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you. You see?
So.
There's nothing here.
Und jetzt bewerten wir sein Spiel gut.
I haven't even finished building this section.
Und dann passiert irgendwas krasses.
Because you were never supposed to be here in the first
place. Ich hab Face Punch eingegeben, ne?
Exposed developer textures.
Junge!
Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you? Do you not think I put a lot of time into that? Because I did. And in the end, it was
wir können
all
gleich gucken, was beim 4-Stunden-Baby-Ending kommt. Help wir können gleich auf YouTube gucken.
Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Work with me, you've given me absolutely nothing so far. Tell you what, let me take a stab in the dark at a new design and you can give me some
feedback. Ich bewerte jetzt richtig gut.
There we go. A third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before.
Oder wollen wir nicht in die Option reingehen? Wollen wir nicht in die Option reingehen? Was machen wir, Chat? Wollen wir nicht in die Option reingehen? Und stattdessen passiert hier irgendwas anderes? Was passiert hier, wenn wir jetzt nicht reingehen? Mitte. Oh.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices?
Das war crazy.
Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here. Aha! You see, I knew I was onto something. Where do these flashes of inspiration come from? How did I know the game needed a third door? Well, it's instinct mostly. A calling in your gut. I really couldn't say where the idea came from, except that I felt it in my soul. You can't teach that, Stanley. Don't even try. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
All right. Schön.
Now, would you say that competitive leaderboard?
Ah, ja, genau. Highscore-Funktion war auch sick. Genau, das haben wir auch schon. Doors.
Again, honest answers, please. Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting. You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you?
Perfect. Es hat nichts verändert. Es hat nichts verändert. Ja, unbeliebtes Ding, ich bin für Spam Sub.
The baby crawls left towards danger. You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game.
Jungs, ich spiele jetzt nicht dieses dumme Babyspiel für 4 Stunden, Real Talk nicht. Ich spiele das jetzt nicht für 4 Stunden.
I think the art world will really take notice. But of course, the message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective? Be sure to keep notes on your experience.
Jungs, wollt ihr das jetzt für 4 Stunden haben? Okay. Skunk Gang. Jungs. Okay, ist vorbei, oder? Nach 2 Stunden wird's schwerer. Okay, jetzt können wir der Scheiß auf das Baby. Ah, doch nicht. Okay, nochmal. Oh, fuck. Ja, scheiße, aber ab ins Feuer.
You heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because if it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of
ideas.
I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me. I'm not even going to try. I'm out. I'm done. It's over. Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable.
Oh, hey, since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game, just to ease the pain? Let's see.
What do we have here?
Und jetzt kommt Minecraft. Kann man da noch was anderes machen?
Yes. This seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot. Well, Stanley, is this any better?
Ist wieder hier.
At last, the one thing you've always desired. A game I had absolutely nothing to do with. But is it enough? Tell me that, Stanley. Will it ever be enough? Well, I'll say this. I'm done making
Jungs, ist das Ending jetzt hier?
From now on, I will only create to fulfill a greater
Geh schnell runter.
Purpose.
Okay.
Watch this, Stanley. I'm going to build a house.
Bäume abbauen.
This will go here. No, here. And then... Let's see, what does it need? I, yes, of course. And
just to
finish it all off... Yes.
Wer's gedacht?
It's complete. I made this, Stanley. Look at it. Gaze upon my work of art and feel ashamed at your own inadequacy. Ah, but you've only seen it from the outside. You've only gotten half the experience.
Please, Jungle
step
Lock,
inside
fünf
and
through.
Make yourself comfortable.
Und rein.
Isn't it grand? Isn't it perfect?
Das ist perfekt.
It could only be better if... Wait, that's it. We must rebuild it out of diamond.
Wenn Senpai sich dann
diamond
hochbaut.
Everything. Yes, yes, yes. Come along, Stanley. We have to go mining.
Geh nicht.
Oh my, it looks like it's going to get a bit dark. Have you brought a light? Oh no, 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 no. This is far more open-ended than I had in mind. I'm looking for something more narrow and linear. Something that makes you feel utterly irrelevant. This won't do at all. 1 out of 5.
Oh, hier geht's gar nicht weiter.
Save this one. Okay, new game. Yes, I don't even know what this game is, but I love it. You, trapped in a glass box with no way out, listening to me talk. Oh, it's inspired. I couldn't have done it any better myself. What is this game even supposed to be? I can't figure it out. Okay, now I'm curious. Let's go find out what the hell this is.
Nein! Kann sich mitnehmen! Okay, wir haben's.
Oh, it's a puzzle. Critical thinking, Stanley. You're 40.
Wer hat das schon? Hui.
Genius.
This is... Beep, 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 beep.
No, actually, you know what? I think that's plenty. I really don't care much to see you stumble through.
Yo, Basco, danke für den Resub. Jungs, ein Speedrun. Yo, Luca Fatti. Luca Fiatti, danke für den Sub, Homie. Ist das ein Horrorspiel? Jahre. Okay.
I wonder what he found. If what he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story, well, perhaps.
Okay, ich glaube, wir haben for real, wir haben dasselbe Ending.
Wherever he is right
now. Wir haben jetzt alles im Chat. No joke, wir haben alles. Wir haben das Spiel durchgespielt. 2,5 Stunden, wir haben das Spiel durchgespielt.
Soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end to make sense out of the chaos
haben
and
wir?
The fear and the confusion. That's who I am.
Ja, wir gucken jetzt YouTube.
That is what I mean to this world.
Wir gucken bei YouTube jetzt, was noch gibt.
Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way. Once this ends, after it all comes to a close, then I'll be back. The end will be here soon. Very soon. I can wait.
Okay. Chat, wir haben das Spiel durchgespielt.
Let's go! No way!
Wartet. Ja. Wir haben es geklappt, oder? Es war nice. Es war ein richtig gutes Game. Das war ein gutes Game. Jungs, es gibt einfach nichts mehr. Es gibt noch so Enden, die dauern irgendwie 8 Stunden oder so, aber wir gucken uns jetzt mal das auf YouTube an. So. Zack. So, Baby Ending.
Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been fine. Good to see that enthusiasm. Keep it up, Stanley. Just 3 hours and 45 minutes left to go. Okay, so clearly you're in it for the long haul. Although I find it hard not to believe you're simply running a program to click the button over and over automatically. Which kind of ruins the point of the game, don't you think? Wouldn't that take the art out of it? You can tell me in your post-playtest analysis.
Just popping in to say hi.
I hope you weren't expecting more regular intervals of commentary from me, but that's not why you're here, is it? You're here for the game, for the art, for the endlessly spiraling sense of pointlessness and despair. Yes, this is what drives your every action. Keep clicking that button for hope, for freedom.
Jungs, imagine wirklich jemand macht das für 4 Stunden.
Science.
Alter.
For love. Don't ever, ever stop. You know, I've been spending the last 2 hours here embroiled in thought, and it's occurred to me this game is incomplete. It's missing something.
Oh.
It still doesn't have that oomph. What is it, I thought to myself? What could possibly be missing from this incredible experience? And then in a moment of rapture, as though delivered by angels, it came to me. Before this moment, I was blind, but those days are behind us. I now understand the true manifestation of this game. It needs a puppy.
Yo!
That's right. This puppy is being lowered toward an aquarium filled with nothing but piranha. Now, you have to click the second button to avert the puppy's death in addition to the baby's. This is it, Stanley. Art. I did it. Video games are art. Ah, but you have a good 2 hours or so to go, so I'll just let you get to that. No time to waste when there is such a meaningful game
Junge,
to be played.
Bonne chance, ultra stressig.
Mon ami. Ah, good to see both the puppy and the baby are still alive. It warms my heart to see how deeply the message of this game has resonated with you. I can only imagine the joy welling up in your chest, the sheer joy of such pure distilled life essence flowing through your veins. It must be amazing.
There's this fucking trash, ich will das niemals machen.
No, seriously, I'm deeply envious of your position at this very moment. Ah! The joy of artistic expression must be even stronger now. Drink it in, Stanley. Few people on this planet will ever get such an experience. Peer through space and time.
Das ist ein Marco,
the universe oder? Unravels itself at your feet. This is the one true meaning of life. I know we said this would go on for 4 hours, but what if you never stopped? Think about it. You could just keep going forever. Visitors would come from around the world to see the man who never stopped pushing the buttons. You would be famous. That's what you've always wanted, right? To be famous? That and the surging power of artistic beauty to flow through you for all of eternity. You could have both of these things. We'll talk about it when you get there. Have we really been doing this for over 3.5 hours? Goodness, how time flies.
Wouldn't you say it's fun? Gemacht. Ja, ja, ich
oh no, you don't have to answer that. I understand you're quite busy. Just keep at it. Almost there.
Okay. Weiter geht's. Haben wir's? Yo!
Nearly there, Stanley. Art itself is about to burrow into your skull.
Hat er es geschafft?
Are you excited for spiritual immortality? For transcendence and oneness with the beauty and essence of all beings? Just a few seconds now? Here it comes.
Das wäre so nicht wert gewesen. Das jetzt für 4 Stunden gemacht zu haben, das wäre so nicht wert gewesen. Holy shit. Das war's. Irgendwie so Kunst, so eine Kunstparodie. 4 Stunden für so ein Bullshit. Nur um noch weiter getrollt zu werden. Und Safecall, ich hätte bei 3 Stunden 48 gechalkt. Okay. Hold it, es kommt gleich was. Oh, ich liebe dich. Das war's. Holy shit. Wie disappointing ist das denn? Warte, wir haben noch so einen YouTube-Link. Ach so, ja, das hier. Ja, das habe ich auch schon. Junge.
We're saving baby. No, he keep him from a fire.
Ah!
We're fine. So Nott has just asked if.
Warum?
If we die.
Jungs, wenn wir out of content sind, machen wir das, okay?
Really, really happy.
Zwei Minuten.
Thanks, Plaid. Oh my goodness, friends. Oh my goodness, friends.
Nicht schon.
There were some rocky moments there, but for the second year in a row, I believe we are going to have saved a baby and a puppy for 4 hours. Awesome. Oh, friends. Oh, my hands. Oh, my wrists. Oh, know that when you die, I'll.
Oh mein Gott. Alter. Okay. Okay, haben wir sonst noch ein Ending nicht bekommen? Haben wir sonst ein Ending nicht bekommen? Haben wir irgendwas, was wir nicht bekommen haben? Haben wir irgendwas? Gibt safe noch 100. Whiteboard Ending haben wir. Warte, was? Von 2013?
And even thought he might pass out, when suddenly he noticed a keypad next to the filing cabinet.
Oh, warte, das ist ein altes, das ist die alte Version davon, oder?
Stanley had never seen this panel before.
Hä?
And had no idea what combination.
Ach, das ist die Source Engine Version. Okay. Okay, Jungs, aber No joke, stabiles Game, oder?
When I met you in the summer.
Stabil, oder? Clap! Jungs, wir haben Action-Game gespielt.